The Kind Worth Killing by Peter Swanson is a thriller book recommended to me by Emily Fox. I'm really glad I found this book recommendation because this book was a cracking thriller in the vein of, I don't say in the vein of, but it's in the same tone of Gone Girl. And a lot of people are like, oh, Gone Girl is, you know, overrated, but Gone Girl is one of my favorite books. It got me back into reading. Honestly, I was I had a young adult novel phase, and then I kind of grew out of loving reading. And then I went into a graphic novel phase. I still am. But yeah, Gone Girl was the book that got me back in. So this book has a very similar tone. It's a homage to Patricia Highsmith's Strangers on a Train. If you're unfamiliar, Strangers on a Train is about a successful tennis player who talks with a stranger, and they have dinner. And they talk about, you know, how to get away with the perfect murder. And this stranger says, hey, I have an idea. Why don't you kill someone for me and I'll kill someone for you? And the guy doesn't take it seriously. But it's basically like a, you know, a murder story involving civilians. So this one is very similar. Ted is kind of drunk. He's on his like third or fourth martini. He's at a bar waiting. Airport lounge, actually, waiting at a bar. And he's waiting for his flight when a woman compliments his drink, you know, his beautiful petite redhead with pale skin. And he starts talking with her, he starts spilling his guts and saying, you know, his wife is cheating on him and he'd love to kill her. And this woman takes like a weird interest, and they're talking to each other on the plane, and they formulate a plan. So this book starts off with a wicked intro and it just sucks you in. The first half of this book is literally just like, I couldn't put it down. I blew through like half this book within a day. It's one of those, I don't want to, you know, stop reading. And when I go to work, I want to read the book. And when I get off work, I want, you're thinking about the book. And so the book juggles two different perspectives. There's Ted, you know, reeling with this, or not reeling, but he's dealing with this new, you know, aspect, you know, like, is this woman really going to help him commit the perfect murder and get away with it? And then we also explore the woman as well. We get some flashbacks of her childhood and, like, you know, her deal, basically. And this book is a near perfect book for me. Honestly, it had me riveted from the beginning. Slows down in the middle a little bit. Ending is really nice and satisfying too. But the reason why I can't give this book a full 5 stars has to be this sort of unfocused tangent writing. You know, there's a lot of backstory given to each of the characters. You know, it makes them feel real. You know, you find out where they go to school, what their parents are like. But then they sometimes give up too much detail, like to the point where it just bores you. You know, like, it's the equivalent of like you're standing in line for something, and this person next to you starts talking to you, like, you know, small talk. And then all of a sudden they go, my father's name was Gerald and my mother's name was Olivia. They met at a charity function ball. They fell in love, and he's you know, a professor at Barnard College, and she works as a secretary in a dentistry office. Her favorite color is purple, and not obviously I'm you know, indulging, but it's like that, you know, like, I don't want to dive too deep into these people's lives if it doesn't affect the story, you know, like, why mention that this character has a brother if that character's never gonna, like, be of anything. Like, I honestly thought like the sort of deep dives into all these backgrounds was a way to hide information, you know, like, you're gonna mention a brother and then all of a sudden at the end, like, oh, the brother is like instrumental to the plot. But it's not like that at all. It's just, it almost feels like fluff. And if it weren't for all, there's a lot of it. And there's also one, like, terrible typo where the wrong person's name is put there. And I had to, like, stop reading and go back, and it ruined the flow. And it's not a big deal, but, like, come on, man. You know, you can't have the wrong name in the middle of a page, you know, like, because, you know, not a typo, but, like, you know, it just kind of, like, it was jarring. And so for that, I have to give this book a 4.5 out of 5, which is the highest score I've probably given a book, because I really liked this book. It was like a breakneck pace, really morally gray characters. I noticed that a lot of people on Goodreads, I wanted to read the negative reviews, they're complaining that the author is a misogynist because the women in this book are not painted as angelic. But that's the thing I liked, you know, people like Gone Girl because it's unique. You can't say, automatically assume that an author is a misogynist because they write morally gray female characters. You know, that's just real life. You know, there's a lot of shitty people out there. They can be men or women. And it's great to see a nice, you know, femme fatale once in a while. And I really liked the way that the book unravels. And what I especially liked is that it doesn't whimper out. You know, a lot of thriller books, they go like, oh, well, let's just wrap up everything nicely. And this book's like, no, let's keep going. Let's make it, you know, juicy. And I really like that. So this book, 4.5, I definitely recommend this book. I will definitely be checking out all of the thrillers from this author. I mean, I think he's got 5 books out. So I'm down. And that's my thoughts on The Kind Worth Killing by Peter Swanson.